in Virginia was an oven. All the kids eating ice cream with their cousins. I was studying while you was playing the dozens. Don't act like you was there when you wasn't. Running from the man, running from the badge. Don't act like you was there when you wasn't. Running toward our plans and the judge's hands.
Hello, and thank you for joining us. The new Sigma Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated proudly recognizes the arts. Our sorority emphasizes the importance of the arts, exposing members of the community to arts enrichment and culture by focusing on visual and performing arts, and by showcasing talent through the exploration of writers, entertainers, and various other artists. Today, in celebration of Black History Month, we pay tribute to the evolution and influence of African American music. Journey with us back in time when African slaves were brought to the US and forced to develop new ways of communicating that would ultimately change the sounds of their music. As we listen to the various genres of African American music over time, with each era presenting a platform for artistic expression and social movements, we become more aware of how that music has helped to soothe, lift, and revive the spirits of the African American community and people all over the world. Again, thank you for joining us, and we hope you enjoy.
In the late 18th century, folk spirituals originated among Southern enslaved people following their conversion to Christianity. Conversion, however, did not result in enslaved people adopting the traditions associated with the practice of Christianity. Instead, they reinterpreted them in a way that had meaning to them as Africans in America. They often sang the spirituals in groups as they worked the plantation fields. Slaves used music to ease the drudgery of their lives and sometimes to send messages. Spirituals allowed slaves to think about a new world where there would be freedom from toil and strife. Folk spirituals were spontaneously created and performed in a repetitive, improvised style. The most common song structures are the call and response and repetitive choruses. The call and response is an alternating exchange between the soloist and other singers. The soloist usually improvises a line to which the other singers respond, repeating the same phrase. Here to give us a glimpse back in time of what could be heard by African American slaves on the plantations of the South are the Brothers of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, Omega Mu Mu Chapter, with Pharaoh's Host Got Lost.
Greetings from Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated, Omega Mu Mu Chapter. My name is Charles Lackey.
My name is Tim Huggins.
My name is Derek Wright.
We'll be singing an old Negro spiritual entitled Pharaoh's Host Got Lost.
Moses, Moses, lay your rod in that Red Sea. Lay your rod, let the children cross in that Red Sea.
King Pharaoh holds God
lost, lost, lost.
King Pharaoh holds God
lost in that Red Sea.
Oh, they shouted when the host got
lost, lost, lost.
They shouted when the host got
lost in that Red Sea.
Yeah, no moment that the host got
lost, lost, lost.
Yeah, no moment that the host got
lost in that Red Sea.
They was weeping when the host got
lost, lost, lost.
Lost
in the Red Sea.
Oh, they sing when the host got
lost, lost, lost.
Oh, they sing when the host got
lost in the Red Sea. Moses, Moses, lay your rod in the Red Sea. Lay your rod, let the children cross in the Red Sea.
Oh, when the host got lost,
lost, lost, lost.
Oh, they shouted when the host got
lost
in the Red Sea. Oh,
those women
when the host got lost.
Lost, lost.
In the early 1800s, it was the singing and dancing of the slaves that inspired the barbershop quartet of the late 1800s. The Black community harmonized recreationally the popular songs of the day, as well as spiritual and folk songs, improvising harmonies according to long-standing African-American musical practice. From their artistic expressions arose certain distinctive musical qualities that are the hallmarks of the barbershop style. Barbershop quartets had exuberant tunes done in four-part harmony and a cappella. In the Old South, slave masters returned profits by leasing enslaved Black barbers to their neighbors and local establishments to mainly groom prominent white men. The Black-owned barbershops were run by slaves or ex-slaves, and it wasn't easy for a Black man to visit a Black barber and get a haircut, not only in the South, but also in the North. For some ex-slaves and free African-American men, being a barber was a better alternative to working in the fields. Barbers were also known to be songsters, and the services they provided not only included the luxuries of grooming, but musical entertainment for their clients' viewing and listening pleasures. American barbershops formed social and musical centers for men. Historical articles penned by James Weldon Johnson note that every barbershop back then seemed to have its own quartet. Here to perform the soulful harmonies that closely resemble the harmony and a cappella of the barbershop quartet is the Jones family with Strengthen Me Where I'm Weak.
Boom, boom, boom. Oh. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, Lord. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, I'm asking you one more time.
Strengthen me where The end of the Civil War freed the slaves, but the cotton glut after Reconstruction left most of the South desperately poor. A new form of music born in the Mississippi Delta out of depression and poverty swept the country, known as the blues. The makings of the blues began in the 1860s, and the very first reported blues show was in 1916 in Jacksonville, Florida, performed by Gertrude Rainey, better known as Ma Rainey, a forerunner for this style of music. The social significance of blues music resides in the revolutionary element of African Americans creating their own aesthetics. Blues music represented the opposing voice that refused to be silenced by oppression and segregation. The blues expressed this with unprecedented clarity, honesty, and simplicity. The blues didn't spread out significantly from the South to the Midwest until the 1930s and 40s. Once the Delta blues made their way up the Mississippi to urban areas, the music evolved into electrified Chicago blues, other regional blues styles, and various jazz blues hybrids. A decade or so later, the blues gave birth to rhythm and blues and rock and roll. Performing his original song, Use Me, is Jay Fitz.
Hey, I'm Jay Fitz. I'm a Southern Soul Blues artist, and today I will be doing an original. It's called Use Me, and I want to dedicate this performance to Sean Rogers. He was a good friend who became family, and he's truly missed. Here we go. La-da-da. Tell my baby, use me till you use me up. Every day of the week, girl. Use me till you use me up. But baby, please don't throw me away. Y'all mind if I sing that one more time? Use me, oh, baby, I want you to use me, girl. Use me, yeah, yeah. I want you to use me till you use me up. But baby, please don't throw me away. This is for my fellas here. On Saturday, I just wanna watch. I wanna watch me some Mississippi State football. But my baby, she's got a different game. She's got a different game for me. Let me tell y'all what she got me doing. Got me mowing the grass. She got me trimming the hedges. She got me doing all sorts of things. Baby girl, you got me begging. Baby, please give me a break. But you keep on using me. Hey, baby, I want you to use me, girl. This is what I tell my baby. Every day of the week, use me. Use me. I said, use me, baby, like you never used me before, girl. I said, use me. Use me. I said, use me, baby, like you never used me before. Listen, baby, I want you to use me how you use that cell phone when you're talking to your girlfriends all night long. Listen, baby, I want you to use me. Use me till you get tired, baby. Ooh, I want you to use me, babe, like you never used me before. You know, sometimes I be having to beg my baby. I said, you. I want you to use me, yeah, baby, use me, baby. Hey, I'm Jay Fitz, and I'm glad to be a part of this. Thank y'all, and I love y'all. I'm out of here.
From the depths of World War I, a new sound began sweeping the world. It is believed that out of the blues came the birth of jazz music. Of course, jazz wasn't born on a particular day. It was created over time. It was a meeting, a mixing, and a melding of many cultures, many emotions, and many skills. Some say jazz was born in 1895, the year Buddy Bolden started his first band. Others say it happened in 1917 when Nick LaRocca and his original Dixieland jazz band recorded the first jazz record, Livery Stable Blues. Originating in New Orleans, jazz was the instrumental equivalent of the barbershop quartet. Understandably, any phenomenon as popular as jazz would surely spawn several variations and themes. In Kansas City, Charlie Parker introduced brass to jazz, bringing in swing rhythms and saxophones and trumpets. In Chicago, the first jazz soloist appeared. Many, like Louis Armstrong, would become famous in their own right. In New York, the jazz swing rhythms were amplified into full-scale orchestras, thus ushering in the swing era. Duke Ellington, Cab Calloway, Dizzy Gillespie, and Count Basie all had bands, and the Cotton Club in Harlem became the premier destination to hear the variations of jazz music. Performing Duke Ellington's A-Train is the Itawamba Community College Jazz Band.
Thank you. Summertime, a popular jazz tune composed in 1934 by George Gershwin and written by DuBose Hayward for the 1935 opera Porgy and Bess, became a much recorded jazz standard, described as one of the finest songs the composer ever wrote. Gershwin's highly evocative writing brilliantly mixes elements of jazz and the song styles of Blacks in the Southeast United States from the early 20th century. Hayward's inspiration for the lyrics was the Southern folk spiritual lullaby, All My Trials, a folk song which became popular during the social protest movements of the late 1950s and 1960s. Gershwin insisted that the first production of Porgy and Bess feature an entirely Black cast, a bridge-building gesture that launched several brilliant operatic careers. That said, the first production was not a huge success, and it wasn't until after Gershwin's death in 1937, at age 38, that Porgy and Bess grew in importance, succeeding on Broadway as well as becoming accepted as serious opera and becoming the source of several of the most famous tunes in popular music. Of all those tunes, the most popular and enduring is Summertime. It is one of the most covered songs of all time, with more than 25,000 known recordings by artists of every kind. While it has a distinctive style in its original form, something about it makes it endlessly adaptable. Joining us to perform the timeless Summertime is Stephanie Stubbs.
Americans migrated from rural southern towns to northern urban cities
their musical stylings, and forms of worship followed, there's no doubt that gospel music has been a cornerstone in the African-American community since the Christianization of African slaves in the United States. Traditional gospel music was popular in the mid-20th century. It is the primary source for urban contemporary gospel and Christian hip-hop, which rose in popularity during the late 20th century and early 21st century. Chicago became an epicenter for gospel music shortly after the turn of the century. Gospel artists and composers collaborated with secular musicians who played piano, guitar, and brass instruments. Starting in 1945 through the 1960s, the golden age of gospel music, famed singers like Thomas A. Dorsey and Mahalia Jackson took the genre to new heights. Thomas A. Dorsey was a son of the Southern Baptist preacher and is now considered the father of gospel music. He pioneered the sound by blending spirituals and traditional worship music with blues, jazz, and swing. The new gospel music composed by Dorsey and others proved very important among quartets who began turning in a new direction. Groups such as the Dixie Hummingbirds, the Pilgrim Travelers, the Soul Stirrers, Swan Silvertones, the Sensational Nightingales, and the Five Blind Boys of Mississippi introduced even more stylistic freedom to the close harmonies of Jubilee style, adding ad-libs and using repeated short phrases in the background to maintain a rhythmic base for the innovations of the lead singers. Joining us now with one of his original songs, "He Never Let Me Down," is Josh Miles.
I've had so many my
Rhythm and blues, also known as R&B, which combines soulful singing and a strong backbeat, was the most popular music created by and for African Americans between the end of World War II and the early 1960s. The early development of R&B occurred in tandem with the second migration of African Americans who moved from the southern and rural regions of the United States during and after World War II. Through the emergence of soul as the major Black popular music, rhythm and blues not only registered the hardships and frustrations of urban African American life and its core views and values, but it also expressed African Americans' most cherished post-war achievements and ongoing aspirations. Black popular culture, as with the more mainstream aspects of US popular culture that African Americans embrace, serves a socio-political function when and where it offers an arena where African Americans can create and critique alternative views and values, as well as an arena where they can explore and express traditional African American views and values. R&B initially developed during a 30-year period that bridges the era of legally sanctioned racial segregation, international conflicts, and the struggle for civil rights. The name itself was controversial. R&B was a general marketing term that denoted African American music, and it was created to replace the term race records. These efforts were done to appeal more strategically to white audiences. As racial divides intensified around the country, R&B music found a broad cross-cultural appeal with the young listeners who would amplify the significance of the music to audiences at large and ultimately society. Get ready to be taken back by the empowering sounds of protest in one of our country's most revered anthems in support of the civil rights movement. Performing Sam Cooke's A Change Is Gonna Come, it's Lawrence McKenzie.
I was born by the river in a little tent. Oh, just like the river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh yes it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid die, 'cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh yes it will. Said I go and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me, fella, don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. I say, brother, won't you help me please? But he winds up knocking me back down to my feet. Oh, there's been times when I thought I would last so very long. But now I know that I'm able to get just gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. I wish I could encourage somebody today and let you know that it changed. It's coming your way. It's coming your way. You just hold on. You just keep the faith. It's gonna change. Oh, yes, it will.
You can't speak on the significance of R&B without noting the legendary R&B sounds of Motown. Over 62 years ago, Berry Gordy Jr. set up the hit factory of Motown. Its catalog was an irresistible force of social and cultural change, leaving its mark on not just the music industry, but society at large. With its catchy melodies and universal messages, the Motown sound has become one of the most significant musical accomplishments and stunning success stories of the 20th century. Motown greats such as Marvin Gaye, The Temptations, Smokey Robinson, and Diana Ross, to name a few, helped pave the way for today's R&B artists and challenged the world to take notice of the prolific contributions of African American music artists. Thanks to their popularity, African American songs and faces entered the homes of every American in the country, regardless of race. Urban contemporary music, as it came to be called, was a musical genre of the time that was defined by recordings of rhythm and blues or soul artists with broad crossover appeal. Urban contemporary began as an American radio format designed to appeal to advertisers who felt that Black radio would not reach a wide enough audience. Through innovation and influence, Black artists have consistently reshaped and merged popular music. Pop music or popular music is intended to be received and appreciated by a wide audience. Modern pop stars of all races would not exist in their current forms without African American musical influence. In nearly every genre of pop music, Black musicians have had a significant impact. Pop stars like Michael Jackson and Prince represent the infusion of Black music into the American mainstream. The soul of R&B is compelling and undeniable. Endless recordings have crossed over into the pop charts in the US, Britain, and elsewhere, proving its capacity to capture a diverse audience. The musical crossover created a style where African-American artists were free to make music only bound by vastness of their influences. It allowed these talented artists to build a musical emergence that made music so significant, they became the creators of a new sound that has lasted the test of time. This genre incorporates elements of jazz, R&B, soul, gospel, rock, funk, and blues. Here to help us experience African American ingenuity and a skillful blend of music genres is Just Gia, with a soulful rendition of River Rise by India Arie.
There was always a power I could feel. It was guidance to tell me the way to go. But nowadays, I feel like I can't hear that voice. I have been flying blind. I need you to come and be my eyes. Be my eyes, River Rise. Carry me back home. Cannot remember the way, River Rise. carry me back home. I surrender today. I was always a crown flower child. I would sit for hours and listen to the sky. But nowadays, I feel like I don't have that choice. I've been looking down in desperation. I need you to be my inspiration. My inspiration. River, rise. Carry me back home. I cannot remember the way. River, rise. Carry me back home. I surrender today. I bow down and I humble myself. I can't do this. Lord, I need your help. All the material things, they feel just like chains. If you're not here beside me, you're the reason I see. River, rise, carry me back home. I cannot remember the way. River, rise, carry me back home. I surrender today. I surrender today. Remember the way. I surrender today. Yeah. I cannot remember the way. River, rise. Carry me back home. I cannot remember the way. River, rise.
R&B and its many variations is a testament to how music in the African American community is one of the greatest forms of expression and platforms for artistic brilliance that is forever evolving. The evident appreciation for the earlier sounds of R&B can be heard in the arrangements of more current R&B sounds. Artists like Boyz II Men, Mariah Carey, and Whitney Houston were blurring the lines between different styles, creating the blended genre that we know as contemporary R&B. Contemporary R&B developed after years of urban R&B. Like urban, contemporary R&B is slickly produced, but many of the musicians are motivated to bring the grit, spirit, and ambitiousness of classical soul back to contemporary soul and R&B. From its earliest days, it has tended to be a radio-friendly style, boasting smooth productions and prominent lead vocalists. One of the most identifiable elements of contemporary R&B is its frequent use of a melisma singing style, where one syllable is stretched out to sustain a rippling voice effect. As contemporary R&B has aged, it has tended to incorporate musical innovations of the day, including keyboards, drums, and horns, which all work to create richly textured mixtures. The lyrical content is usually light, focusing on love and melodrama. The vocals are used to build a connection to soul, while the drum beats provide a hip-hop flair to the storytelling technique of the musical artist. Feel that connection to contemporary R&B music as you listen to the PC Band performing their new hit single, Let Me Love You.
Hey, man, this song is entitled Let Me Love You, man, from my new EP, man, Love Therapy. Check it out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh. If I had a dime for every single time that I seen a woman cry, I would be richer than most, but I don't want that, no. If I had a time machine, I would travel back to the day before your heart and take away the tears, the clouds, the... That's not how love should go. Everyone makes me. How much can a heart take before it? I don't wanna add pressure. I just wanna let you know I'm better than what you had before. You should let me
love you. I'll show you better than I tell you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I don't ever
think
nobody's gonna love you like
I can, baby. I just wanna
love you. I
can
show you better than I tell you.
They
don't ever
think
nobody's
gonna love you
like
nobody don't love you, yeah. Love you. If you had a chance to love again, I hope you wouldn't think. Cause every woman needs a good man, someone who's gonna make you a wife. I know you've heard it all before, good and the bad. You're tired of playing those little games. No, I'm not perfect, but I'm worth it. And this time it won't be the same. Everyone makes me. How much can a heart throw it? I don't wanna add pressure. I just wanna let you know I'm better than what you had before. You should have let me
love you.
Oh, yeah.
I show you better than I tell you. But they don't ever think
nobody's gonna love you. Ain't nobody gonna love you, guys.
Like
I just wanna
love you.
Yeah.
I can show you better than I tell you.
Oh, yeah.
No,
I just wanna love you, baby. I just wanna. I just wanna love you, baby. I just wanna. I just wanna. Don't you want? You should let me.
You should let me.
Oh, no, no, no.
I can show you better than I tell you.
Tell you. Ain't nobody gonna love you, baby. I just wanna love you. I just wanna tell you. Y'all hear me tell them. Squeezing on your body, baby. You know I really love you, lady.
By the 1980s, problems in urban living had reached a climatic level. Poverty, crime, drugs, and violence threatened to tear apart the fabric of African American life. In this emotional maelstrom, a new form of music was born. It was a lament against urban poverty, like the blues had been a lament against rural poverty. Also like the blues, it touched a chord and quickly spread everywhere. Early rap skipped instruments entirely, just using lyrics and a bass beat. It became most popular when it morphed into hip hop and returned some instruments to the mix. Some hip hop remains reflective of the hard life on the streets, but many artists have moved more mainstream. Performing his original song, Down on My Luck, is Jet Brown.
Thank you.
But confused by deception, they run it with gifts of man, but they don't have a lethal weapon. I check it, so I sympathize with the real user. Cause life's so hard that the result of pipe shooting, tubing, smoking, or whatever to get a head change. Same team, different game, ref call the same thing. Wow, like we got an X on our chest with no vest. You can't shoot back, no Smith and West. Yes, that's the way I like a knife and a gunfight. Underdog wins when it's Friday night, lights ride. Disagreeing, get charged with a penalty. Take back the sympathy to check weapon lethally. Lethally weapon check the sympathy. Take back the penalty to charge when we disagree. Wanna be better than any level, so incredibly, incredibly better than any level I was born to be. Straight up on my hood, don't that fear of getting Trayvon. You know, like running into a Zimmerman. No flags flown in the face of the guilty. PC raising all shame, threat to penance to the thing. He's a morse for the cold, kill the wicked, took a week to kill the cold. Cause a mouthful to speak, preach. No sermon, need to speak it from the heart to beat it. Boom, boom, another kid has died this evening.
It's the story that's ignited fierce passions across the nation as allegations of racism and miscarriage of justice tear apart a small Florida town. 3 weeks ago, Trayvon Martin, an unarmed black teenager, was shot down by a white neighborhood watchman who claimed self-defense and has not at this point been arrested.
The largest police force is facing a serious controversy over a video that went viral showing officers arresting a suspect who later died. The video is wrenching, and here's David Martin.
Notice, man. Every time you point your finger, you got three looking back at you. Let that sink in.
The influence of African-American music is unquestionable. As we've seen tonight, African-American music is one of the most poetic and inescapable examples of the importance of the African-American experience to the cultural heritage of all Americans, regardless of race or origin. The members of the Nu Sigma Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated want to thank all of the musical artists for participating in this production. We also want to thank Jamil Lasley with Shots Fired Media Group for your time and effort in assembling this body of artistic expression. Finally, we want to thank you, our viewers, for enjoying and watching the evolution of African American music. We hope that you have a new love and appreciation for this art and its infusion into the American culture. Thank you and good night.